I think that the G20 are more serving the interest or the of their proper investors than the interest of our continent, and it's I feel like it is an offensive politics towards our country, our countries. Yes. I think that Tunisia was in a difficult situation. This meeting of the G20 reminds me the meeting of the G7 after the revolution, where the countries and the financial institution have decided to resolve the financial crisis after the revolution by giving more loan to Tunisia. But these loans that we have from these financial institutions have been made with a set of conditionalities to set a new framework to the investors to lock their interest, to give them more protection inside the country, and to give them more protection for repatriate their benefits. So we are locked into a debt trap, and we were forced to engage into regulatory changing framework inside our countries. So I think that this is a broader framework for Africa. Maybe it succeeded with Tunisia, so why not do it also with Africa? For example, one of the preconditions to have to sign the standby agreements was to adopt a new law on central bank, and the law on central bank gave more independence to central bank. Giving more independence to central bank doesn't mean that it gives them more prerogative to be an actor inside the economy, but to limit their prerogatives in a term that, for example, one of the objectives of the central bank was to target inflation, not to target unemployment, not to give credit to the government, for example, for the budget. So this law was for the purpose of netting the country more dependent on the financial institution. There is another precondition was to change the investment law. And inside the investment law, there was a big fight inside the parliament regarding the property of lands. If we can give the agricultural land to foreigners or not. And another another article in the investment law was about dispute settlement mechanism. And introducing this dispute settlement mechanism in the investment law was, by the way, securing some Singapore issues inside the internal legal framework instead of negotiating it in the framework of the free trade agreements. I think that we need to think about how the government could create fiscal policies, marge de manoeuvre, in the sense that they permit new industrial policies that are oriented into job creation, technology transfer, and also policy for agriculture that ensure the food sovereignty and not being only a supplier of raw material for the other countries. I think that it is not helpful to go into negotiation with the G20 because it's a matter of structure of power. And we need to know what are the institutions that permit this kind of negotiation. And the G20 cannot be an institution where people, where governments can negotiate with such less powers. We are glad that this alternative summit happens also in Germany, because we feel that European people have the main concerns that our people in Africa, because they are also suffering from the consequence of the globalization. Not only Africa is a victim. So this kind of solidarity is very important, and to have this link between the people to think about which alternative we want to this world.